Hey everyone, Shadow here, and welcome to another Marvel Contest of Champions video. So it's Season 9, and this is War Number 6, so we're halfway through the season. And we're going up against an alliance called Mayhem of the Battle Realm. And I believe we faced them before, but you can see the team that I decided to go in here with. I did scout my path, and AQ is not running currently, so I was able to bring in Corvus. He has been my main Alliance War attacker for a while, but my Alliance has switched to an Alliance Quest focus. So the only time that I'm going to bring Corvus in is if Alliance Quest is down, which it is right now. I wish I had a 6-star Corvus, then I could bring him into Alliance War. All right, so first node up was a mutant. And, of course, I was going to go in here with Corvus. Now, these early nodes are going to have the weaker defenders. They are what I call diversity nodes. The defenders that are placed here are generally just included for diversity purposes. All right, so you can see we're just ripping through this beast, not having any problem whatsoever. But then again, we didn't expect it. But Alliance War does have a habit of surprising you with dropped inputs and other fun mechanics. But we didn't have a problem there. Next up, we've got a Mystic on the poison node. This is why I brought in Red Hulk. He's poison immune. This was a Mystic. Sometimes I bring in Iceman, sometimes I bring in Hyperion, but I wanted to try out Red Hulk. And I am running Suicide, so that helps him out quite a bit. As you can see, he started off with nice heat charges, and because he's going up against this Morningstar, you see he ramped up his heat charges very quickly. Now, this is not a bad placement. She has a chance, because she's awakened, she has a chance to inflict a bleed every time she's struck. But Red Hulk just did so much damage so quickly that it didn't really matter. And this is the only fight that I brought him in here for, so no big deal. All right, so now we've come to the last leg of my journey. This is the last part of my path, and I decided to just go ahead and pop a 10% boost on, just because I have about 6 of them in my overflow. All right, so this first guy, 9 times out of 10, if it's a Cosmic, it's going to be Hyperion. And it was. I even checked the guy's profile. And so I was pretty sure this was Hyperion. Now, the reason that I brought Starkey in here, despite having class disadvantage, he has 2 things in his arsenal that make him a pretty good option for this. One, he has a power drain on his heavy, and it has a cooldown. I wish they gave a better indication of the cooldown. But he has that power drain, as you see right there. And he also has a taunt. So those 2 things together can help keep Hyperion from getting to a special 3. All right, so this Hyperion has got me in the corner, and then I could see right here that he was not about to throw that special. So I went ahead and just went all in, hoping for some crits, and I got him. That was very fortunate. If I did not get those crits, this may have turned out a little bit differently. I may have survived his special 3, but I'm happy that I didn't have to find out. So next up, we have another Cosmic, and this is Unblockable Special 1, though. And I toyed around with the idea of bringing in Corvus for this, but why? I want him for the mini-boss. Not going to get a mission from this. I couldn't remember anyone that could give me a mission for the Cosmic, so I played it safe, brought in my Starkey. He had good health, and it turns out to be Spider-Man Symbiote. Now, the only tricky part about Spider-Man Symbiote is when he fires off a special, he gets that spider sense, and he evades like crazy. Alright, so what I'm doing here is I built up to my poise charges, my max 10 poise charges, then I went in for the attack. And you'll see here, I backed off before he got his special 1, and then finished him off, so that he never had a chance to fire his special 1 off. So you don't always have to go hard in. Sometimes it's more strategic to get them almost to that first bar of power, back off, then do a full combo and finish them off. And since I had already built up all those poise, just ripped them apart. All right, so next up, this is Bane. This node can be very, very fun. It's a science champion. Turns out to be Miles Morales. Now, Miles Morales has these evade charges. As you see, he evades like crazy while he has the charges up. So he evaded. I tried to hit him with a heavy so I could complete my evade mission, and he evaded on the last hit. And I've seen that happen quite often. Look at that, twice in a row. And I don't think that's a coincidence. I think they have an increased chance on that last hit. All right, but we got him that time. We've got our evade. We've got a couple more charges. We just used them up. Now we can just wreck him. Okay, he's not going to evade anymore at this point. You don't want to use any specials, or else he's going to get more evade charges. So Miles Morales can be tricky, but if you know how to handle him, you shouldn't have too much of a problem dealing with him, even on Bane. So now we've got one last fight, and it's Spider-Man Stark Enhanced. Now, of course, I'm going to bring in Corvus for this, but I could actually do this fight with any of the guys on my team. They can all do this fight, but Corvus is just going to do it faster and easier. So I don't want to push him to his special 2, even though I can evade the first part of it and block the rest. I'm just playing it safe. And just look at the damage Corvus is doing. Okay, so I'm just baiting out that special 1. Got it. I'm going to hit him just one time. He's got another special 1. Bait that out. Hit him a couple more times. Well, one time there. And just go in. Boom. And he's down. Just that quickly. All right. So at this point, the war is still going on. I finished my path pretty early. So I will be back and we'll find out how we did in this war. And we're back, and as you can see, we did lose. No surprise there. We were going for the bosses, but we only managed to get one boss down, so that's going to hurt us at the end of the season. But I'm expecting us to be gold, maybe one or two. We're just collecting those rewards. The rewards for Alliance quests are so much better. But in any case, congratulations to Mayhem of the Battle Realm. Until next time. Click like, subscribe, leave a comment. Let me know what you thought about this video. And you guys have a blessed day.